Hello everyone, I hope all of you are in good condition and healthy. Still with me Party Roseate, on this occasion, I will explain about how to operate the cement production process in the kiln system. This is a display monitor simulation program for operating the kiln system, with two string-line preheaters and five cyclone levels. This simulation program is equipped with several important parameters, which are used to control the process, including O2, CO, SO2 and NOx in the top cyclone line 1 and line 2, and then at the kiln inlet there are also SO2, NOx, O2 and CO. Then it is also equipped with control of the degree of calcination from the bottom of the cyclone after going through the process in the calciner. And this is also equipped with heat consumption, whose units are kilojoule per kilogram of clinker. If you want to convert it to kilocalorie per kilogram of clinker is divided by 4.18. Before we start the operation of this kiln, we must first observe the hot gas flow and the material flow. This type of calciner is a downdraft whose burner is at the top of the calciner, and this is the tertiary air duct from the cooling system. Here there is a calciner burner which is divided into the calciner riser duct and to the tertiary air duct. Then in each line in cyclone number 4 from above there is a dividing gate. Some of the material is fed into the calciner riser duct and also into the tertiary air duct. This is for line 1 and line 2. Then there is a button to start raw meal batching or silo discharge. The material is removed from the silo to fill the feeding bin, which is prepared for kiln feed, to line 1 and to line 2. Before starting the preheating, the heating up procedure curve must be made first, for example for 12 hours, 16 hours, 24 hours, or 36 hours of preheating. This depends on how long the kiln stops, or how many meters of fire bricks in the kiln are replaced. This is an example for preheating for 24 hours. In this curve the temperature rise ranges from 30 to 40 degrees Celsius, then at a temperature of 600 degrees it is held in order to provide expansion opportunities. Between brick and brick, between refractory brick and shell kiln, and between kiln shell with tire kiln. Then after enough time, at the 17th hour, the temperature was started to increase until the kiln inlet temperature was 900 degrees Celsius and it was ready to start feeding. To start preheating, the first thing we have to do is open the hot gas flow path from the preheater system to the kiln filter. We click button kiln filter. Because the kiln filter is already running, we just need to adjust the damper opening and the ID fan speed. We open the damper about 50%. Then later for the need for the amount of air intake by adjusting the ID fan speed. Then the hot gas flow from the preheater system passes through the conditioning tower, and it is divided into two way, to the raw mill system and to the kiln filter. Because the raw mill system is still stopped, the damper is closed at 0%, then what goes to the kiln filter, we open 100%. Because the draft after the preheater is still positive, we must increase the speed of the ID fan kiln filter. We increase the speed by about 10 to 20% until the SP fan draft is minus to prepare to start the SPID fan. If your preheater system is equipped with a stack damper or fresh air damper, then to start firing you don't need to start the SPID fan, but just open the fresh air damper. Because this simulation program is not equipped with a fresh air damper, we have to run the SPID fan. With a damper opening and a minimum speed. We click the preheater button, then click the start button in the start group, and we wait for the process. After the SPID fan runs, then open the damper from 10 to 20%, and the minimum ID fan speed or from 3 to 5%. Then we observe, if the draft on the top preheater is too high, it can reduce the damper opening. And every time there is an alarm, we have to reset it with the right click and then press acknowledge, so as not to disturb our concentration in doing this process. Before starting firing, the great cooling fan, especially in chamber 1, must be run. Its purpose is to assist the air in the combustion process in the main burner, and to maintain a balanced draft in the kiln hood. In this simulation program, to run the cooling fan in room 1, you have to run a transportation system that goes to the clinker silo in order to run the ID fan cooler. Next, we start the cooler ID fan so that the cooling fan is ready to start. After the cooler ID fan is running, then we start the cooling fan in room 1 and open the damper, or the speed is 10%. After the hot gas path from the kiln leading to the preheater and to the kiln filter is safe, then we are ready to do heating up kiln according to the planned time. That was the explanation about the preparation of kiln preheating. In the next session, we will explain how to do kiln preheating safely according to the procedure. Thank you for watching this video, hopefully it's useful, and don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share. And see you in the next video.